Both machines now pre-stage. In goes Mason McGaha. McGahey's car has problems early. He had a huge starting line advantage of some 5/100ths of a second, but the tune-up was not good enough to carry him to the finish line under power. For Dallas Glenn, 661.3, a 206.95, and a part of me believes, Tony, Dallas might have been thinking a little bit about Aaron Stanfield, and now he took a shot to pull away from him even further.
Well, Dallas Glenn picked up another victory here in Pro Stock. You know, this is a guy who is truly a student of the game. He wins the race and is beating himself up about him late on the tree. You said that you've been flickering the bulb and doing all kinds of goofy stuff, but you're the man holding the wally here today. What was key for you this weekend?
This was definitely a team one here. You know, the crew chief, Dave Connolly, Rob Downey, and Nate Van Wassenhove, they definitely did their job. My engine tuner, Brian Fleck, they've been working really hard. We went testing on Monday, made 11 hits, about killed me. But this is definitely a team. You know, I tried to do my job when we needed to, and they definitely did their job all day long and gave me the absolute killer car. And, you know, it was a little bit of a gamble getting into this new one, but I think it's starting to pay off, and hopefully we can keep the momentum going. But it's great for Rad Torque Systems, DPF Parts Direct, Summit, Jesse, all the sponsors that keep this going. And, you know, I do want to say something for Jerry Haas. You know, he scared us a little bit there on Thursday. We were talking to him, and then the next thing you know, he's going to the hospital. But that and, you know, it's a tough week. Scotty Richardson and Scott Bloomquist for the dirt racing community. Dirt racing's big up here, and you know, I love dirt racing too. But, no, it was a great day. So let's go to Indy and try to get a too fast, too tasty win and seal the deal.